Hey guys, welcome back to the fourth episode of 4ZZZ Off Air. Thank you for watching once again. We're back in our normal green couch. We've gone full circle. Last week we were downstairs in the training room because we had a really serious political spotlight.
Really serious.
Where that was much too much for me. I found it too stressful. So no more political stuff. We're back up here talking about pop stars. We've come full circle. Anyway, I'm Grace.
Claire.
Thanks for watching again. Let's get right into it. So we're going to look at a few records this week as usual. I am taking a look at Zone Out's debut LP, Transients. And what are you looking at, Claire?
I'm looking at Nick Albrock's second solo LP. I'm going to struggle here. It's called Pure Gardeia. And then on Spotlight, we're looking at weird music hookups that have happened this week, because that's a thing on TMZ/4ZZZ off.
That's what this is now. Politics was too much. We talk about one campaign and they're like, oh god, give me some
never
TMZ.
Again.
That's what the green couch is all about.
Yeah. Tell me about your record.
So Zone Out is a guy and a gal from Melbourne. You may know Ashley Bundang from a bunch of other incredible bands, notably Susan, Siggy Witch, and there's one more, Totally Mild. And then it's Doug Bailey, who's on the beats. On the beats? Anyway, Doug Bailey, who does the production side of things, played in Scott Dracula before, but they've come together to produce this really beautiful dream pop outfit kind of thing. But it's an underrated kind of pop. It's not forceful, but it's just like, even the subject matter can get a bit heavy on that album, but even in those darker moments, it's still really sparkly and just like a really bright pop album. Yeah, I'm really digging it. Tell me about Nick Albrock.
Well, most people probably are familiar with his voice or work, albeit as his beginnings in Tame Impala, and then obviously being the frontman of Pond. And this is his second solo record. And as I kind of referenced, I was lucky enough to chat to him about it, so I can just tell you exactly what it's about because he told me. It kind of continues on from his like psych, rock, pop, I guess that weird conglomerate that you've come to expect from Perth. But it's really interesting and quite introspective. The lead single, Advance, is massively a takedown of Advance Australia Fair, the national anthem, and you know, kind of riffing off a lot of that. He also wrote an essay really recently about what it's like growing up in a kind of cultural wasteland like Perth. Not cultural wasteland, but a place that's really isolated, I guess. And how that in and of itself kind of inspires his music. You can go listen to that interview on the New Releases Show page on 4ZZZ if you want. It's interesting.
Interesting.
I mean, on my version, I was awkward. It was awkward. Really awkward.
Great, that's gonna be compelling listening.
Compelling.
Anyway, this week on Spotlight, we're gonna look at weird hookups, not the Tinder kind, but
might be, Tinder guy.
Yeah, well, you never know where Lady Gaga and Kevin Parker would meet each other. Mark Ronson was there, so maybe some kind of like weird three-way music industry elite Tinder.
Yeah, so this photo landed on Instagram the other day. Check it up on the screen for you, but basically it looks like Mark Ronson, who we already know has been working with Lady Gaga on her new album, is also recruiting Kevin to just like come and hang in the studio, which is super weird. And we've mentioned Lady Gaga on the show now, but
I'm okay with it.
We mentioned Beyonce a couple of weeks ago, so it's fine.
And she's like a, you know, she does more than like create outrage. Like, no, your silence disagrees.
No. Yeah, she's a good figure for some people. No, I did that sound okay. Worse than I meant it. But also some weird stuff went down at the Billboard.
Yeah, Billboard Music Awards. Number one, Britney Spears killed a medley of all of her hits from 2000s onward.
I mean, what?
Were you never 10, Claire? Seriously, you can't just undermine Britney Spears like that.
Sorry.
Anyway, that's not what we're here to talk about. Basically, Kesha had a bit of controversy leading up to her performance at the Billboard Music Awards because, you know, really famously now, she wasn't released from her contract with Dr. Luke after the allegations of his sexual assault of her. And he was basically going to veto her performance at the Billboard Music Awards because he was scared that she was going to say something about the case. But after assurances from Kesha's camp that she would just, you know, get up there, do the song and go, he was like, fine. So, you know, that's still kind of something sinister, Dr. Luke still pulling the strings in Kesha's career. But like the weird hookup in this situation is that she did cover of It Ain't Me Babe by Bob Dylan. Kesha, Bob Dylan, not the first like couple that comes to mind when I hear Kesha's gonna do a cover of someone, but sure.
Yeah, and the last weird, I guess, hookup that happened in music this week. It's gonna be bad now that I
think it's the word for it.
So King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard are obviously a pretty cool psych band from Australia. They shared a photo with Bill Clinton the other day.
Did they? Was there any context as to how that came about?
Oh, none whatsoever. They're in America at the moment playing a bunch of shows and playing with Mac DeMarco and a few people like that, and straight up just ran into Bill Clinton and got a photo.
They have so many questions.
Oh, yeah. It was entirely bizarre and kind of funny because there's that classic meme of Bill Clinton crouched over a bunch of records.
Yeah, yeah.
And so obviously, naturally, everyone just created a ton of this ones with him, with like all of the King Gizzard records around him. Very funny.
Was it Nonagon Infinity?
Yeah, he was holding Nonagon Infinity, which is of course their record that came out a couple of weeks ago. And they're also playing on the 25th of June at the Triffid in Brisbane. So maybe you could like go along and ask them what it was like to meet Bill Clinton.
Maybe Bill Clinton will be there.
Maybe he will come all the way just for it.
Who knows? Anything is possible. Weirder hookups have happened.
This week on Stuff We Liked, Grace and I were both super lame and didn't go out this weekend. So we invited Nathan, who works at the station. Hey Nathan.
Hey.
to tell us about a gig that he went to this week. What did you go to this week?
Yeah, I saw Lumpy and the Dumpers at the Haunt last Thursday night with Leather Towel from down in Melbourne. Lumpy and the Dumpers are a band from over in the States, so they made quite a trip over, as well as Bent and Heavy Breather, two local bands. Bent I've seen a thousand times, absolutely love to death, and Heavy Breather, that was the first time. I really liked it because I'm used to hardcore music being really growy and like aggressive, and this was actually like accessible and seemed fun, I guess. And then Leather Tower was kind of like, I don't know, Devo with guitars, which is way down my alley. Yeah, absolutely. And Lumpy and the Dumpers was just raw punk rock music, which is exciting to watch.
Well, I want to talk about Lumpy and the Dumpers as the best name that I've ever heard this year. But I've also never been to the Haunt as a venue. What's it like?
Oh, it's great because it's just like this open room with cool tables down the back, nice smoking area, and people come in and watch the bands, which is what you really want out of the venue.
Cool. Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming.
Yeah,
thanks for dropping by the green couch.
I'm totally not making the cut.
No, you definitely is. We've got nothing else.
He's out. He's really out.
Thanks, Nathan. We should go out this weekend.
Yeah, I'm definitely going out.
Me too.
This weekend, so much.
Oh, so much stuff to not miss that I'm having like a panic attack.
The FOMO is crippling.
So basically, I have Friday off, which I don't seem to have a lot of lately. And there are so many gigs on that I'm legitimately trying to get to multiple. And not like, oh, maybe I'll get you a gig, like in I have a game plan.
Yeah.
There's a map. I've cleared out all the right routes to get from venue to venue.
Do not get in Claire's way.
If you see me on Friday and I look like I'm in a hurry, I am. Leave me alone.
Don't say hey.
So things that are happening. 27th. Today, a big day, in fact. Basically, CMAs are playing at the Zoo. It's sold out, but it's going to be an amazing show. Their record, Hills End, is so good, and this is the first show they've played headline show up here since it came out. Sahara Beck is launching her album Panacea at the Triffid. She's got an 8-piece band with her. It's going to be epic. Last Dinosaurs are doing a last little tour. They're playing at Boundary. And as well, AdCob, otherwise known as A Different Kind of Busy, are playing at the Brightside. So, you know, maybe I'll just see 5 seconds of each one.
And if you're not in the Valley on Friday night, you can catch Ohms at the Bearded Lady for a little bit of garage punk. Carrying on into Saturday, Gabriella Common is back up in town. You may recognise her from The Furs, who haven't put out music in a little bit, but she's been down in Melbourne sorting out her debut album, which I love so much, Full Closure and No Details. She is supporting Sahara Beck on Friday night. Yeah. And she's also doing an in-store at Jet Black Cat on Saturday. Camp Cope are in town for their album launch, and that is at Crowbar on Saturday night. Yeah, and then Melody Pool as well is playing Saturday night.
Yes, there's so much going on this weekend. Which thing? Grace has already just like lost it. You've broken her, Brisbane. You've broken
it's
Grace.
It's too much. I'm back, it's fine.
We're back. But I think that's the end. Again, I always feel so surprised when
it's kind of abrupt.
Gets to the end, we're like, oh, done.
I do love the sound of my own voice, so I'm a bit sad.
Shut us up anytime soon.
Yeah, well, we will be back next week though, so make sure you stay tuned to our Facebook and our YouTube channel. You can watch all of the past episodes there. Thanks for watching again.
And yeah, send your feedback our way, and thanks to popular demand, we are now going to be putting all the songs in the episode at the back of this little credit thing that's about to happen, so watch out.
Does it look okay?
Sure.
I feel like we're all sitting on next.
Yeah, we're all just like, yeah, it's cool.